mood for tapas. Tapas can be a fun social way to eat and entertain, shared bites with flair. Chef Rob Bragagnolo is here with us with some new creative ideas for your next dinner party.
That's
and the
right.
restaurant that you're from?
Marben Restaurant.
Marben Restaurant, where is that?
It's Wellington Street West.
I hear great things about it. I'm going to have
to
come and visit.
Thank you.
What do we have over here before we start cooking over
here? So before we start cooking, this is a very typical Spanish spread, which if me and you were in Spain right now, we went to go eat at a restaurant, we wouldn't just go to one restaurant. We would go to five or six, make stops at each one, have a little bite, glass of wine, and then move on to the next.
I like this. I wish I was there right now.
Yes. Sounds amazing.
And this is something I think I could make. We're going to have this recipe on breakfasttelevision.ca.
That's
it's an omelet.
This is a Spanish tortilla or Spanish omelet. Mm-hmm. So it's basically an omelet that's layered with potatoes and then whatever else you want to put in there. So this has red peppers. You could put,
anything
cod.
You want.
You could put chorizo in there. Anything like this.
Right here?
So this is pan con tomate, which is simply bread with tomato. Mm-hmm. And then you put some Spanish ham on top of that.
Gorgeous.
Octopus, essential for Spanish cuisine. So this is potato with paprika, olive oil, and simmered octopus in red wine.
And just
delicious.
Some bite, some wine.
Yeah, we would have a bite of this, a glass of wine, move on to the next place, and then have another dish, which we're gonna make one right now.
What are we
gonna make?
This
is steamed clams. Okay,
right.
So really important, when you're doing clams, make sure they're closed. If they're open, you
they're
have to
dead.
Get rid of them. They're
not, yeah.
It's not
so you
good.
Can keep them in the fridge for how long? A few days?
Keep them for a few days. You need to rinse them with a lot of cold water and some salt so that they sort of leach out the sand that they might have inside of them, right? So you need a really nice hot pan. And then from here, you can sort of build your flavors, right? So typical Spanish flavors, you would have some ham, right? So that nice ham that we were using for the tomato bread, you start that off there, right?
Clams.
Onion, garlic, some chili peppers to get a little kick. And then very traditional Spanish steamed clams use fava beans when they're in season. Right now in Ontario, beautiful fava beans, so you can use those. All right, so you let that sweat off a little bit, and then you get your clams in there, right?
Okay.
Clams go in.
Where are some places that you would go to buy some clams in Toronto?
Well, there's a ton of places. You can go to St. Lawrence Market. You could go to Kensington Market. There's a couple of grocery stores that have really nice selection of clams. And in Canada, we're really fortunate because we have beautiful mussels, beautiful clams, and scallops.
Wonderful.
Which have a lot of similarities with Spanish food, right?
This is something that I would definitely order at a restaurant, but I would be a little bit intimidated to make at home. But when I see you do it, I'm
like,
I don't do this. This is simple.
And the reason why I chose this is because it takes 2-3 minutes to do. So it's very simple. This is sherry wine, very typical Spanish. You put a little splash of that.
You take a little drink.
Exactly.
You know, I asked a woman, she was 100, and I asked her what her secret was. And she said a little bit of sherry every day.
A little bit of sherry every day.
A little bit of sherry.
I like that.
Yeah, me too.
So lid on.
Yeah.
Okay, and then the steam from the wine, the clams start to open.
Okay.
Right? And then once they're open, you want to take that off immediately.
Immediately, as soon as they open?
Exactly.
Okay, so how long are we leaving this?
This is probably a minute or two max.
A minute or two. Why do we have to do it right away?
Because they toughen up.
Ooh.
So the second that these things open means that they've died.
Okay.
But that's what you're... Right? Sounds a little harsh. But the second they come off, and then you want to eat them, right?
And then we're going to have all those flavors from, from the ham and the onions.
Exactly.
And
earthiness.
Then we can eat that too, though, right?
Oh, of course you can.
Okay.
Eat all of that. Yeah. So that is, you can just put that on in a big bowl in the center of the table for everybody, or you could mix it into pasta, rice. You know, you could have, there's a million different things you can do with that afterwards,
okay,
right?
Like I said, we're going to have all the recipes on breakfasttelevision.ca.
That's
right. You could go to your restaurant.
Marben Restaurant, you could hit it there. Yeah, we have mussels, clams, all that shellfish all the time.
And enjoy wonderful Spanish tapas. Okay,
that's right.
What do we think?
So,
are they opening?
Well, you can see it now, right?
Yeah.
They're starting to open up. See
Come
that
on,
guy
babies.
Right there?
Yeah, I see it.
So that one's fresh, freshly opened.
There you go.
And that guy right there is beautiful to eat.
Can you eat it right now?
You could. I would let it warm up a little bit longer.
So just let it warm up, okay, so that I won't try it yet.
You give it a little mix if you want to, but really what you want to try to do is keep that lid on as long as possible so that that steam helps them to open up.
Wonderful. So we're going to let it steam a little bit more, but these are all the recipes that we're going to have. It's easy peasy, and like I said, I really wanted to make this omelet. This is something that I think that I could definitely do that anybody could do with the potatoes.
Absolutely.
And you could have it not only for breakfast, but any time
of the day.
Breakfast,
lunch, dinner. In Spain, you eat this for dinner most of the time.
This is something for dinner.
Absolutely. And you make it the day before, it tastes even better the next day.
I eat pancakes for dinner sometimes. this would be absolutely perfect. All right, how we do it? There you
go. You see?
Yeah.
So you
gorgeous.
All that stuff is now opening up. See how nice that is?
Yeah, gorgeous.
Right? And you can smell the ham and the earthiness from the paprika and all that coming out.
And then we're going to plate it. We're going to share it with the BT gang
That's
for breakfast.
Right.
This is a perfect breakfast. Okay, so for more information, we can follow you on Twitter. What is your Twitter?
At Marben Resto.
Okay, and we're going to have MarbenRestaurant.com on our website, breakfasttelevision.ca. We're taking a break. We'll see you when we come back on Breakfast Television. A little Spanish tapas.